Alright guys, how's it going? Welcome back to some more Sly 2 Band of Thieves. Last time we finished up episode 7, we did the heist, we did the lumberjack games, and we had our battle with Jean Bassan. We used Bentley in the battle, and we completely wrecked him. We used our smarts to outwit the dumb Jean Bassan, so he's done for. And at the end there, we stowed away inside of the Northern Lights battery, and we made it aboard our Peugeot's blimp. So in this episode, guys, we're going to start up episode 8, and of course, with every new episode, we have a bottle video, and I'm just going to let you guys watch this cutscene really quick. So here it is, Anatomy for Disaster. This is the last episode in the game, guys. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Let's get started with it.
There we were, heading east across the Atlantic Ocean. Stowaways on a giant airborne fortress. Though time was short, we made sure to study up on our unknowing host, Arpeggio. While attending a prestigious boarding school, the young Arpeggio excelled in all subjects, but he never managed to keep up with the other boys physically. Sadly, his wings, due to their small size, were useless for flight. Furious at his feeble body, he focused his powerful mind to search for a cure in the works of the Italian Renaissance masters. Their notebooks provided the springboard for this sinister young genius, and it wasn't long before the Claw Gang took him on as chief inventor. His talents must have been at work repurposing all the clockwork parts for their criminal schemes, and now this mastermind is in possession of all the parts. It's only a matter of time before he puts them back together. And when that happens, well, I'm not gonna let that happen.
Sly Cooper and the gang in Anatomy for Disaster. Alrighty guys, so this is episode 8, and I am pretty excited to get it started. It's the last episode in the game, and we are drawing close to the end of this series, guys. But here we are, 85% done with the game. The last 15% will be wrapped up here in episode 8. So, like always, the first video on a new episode will be a bottle video. Now, just before I get started, the bottles on episode 8 are... I'm just going to let you guys have a look at this blimp before I run around collecting bottles. This thing is humongous. It's not... I mean, it is big, but once you start running around... Or you've played the game a few times, it doesn't seem that big anymore, but hopefully, just, you know, distant memory from playing the last few times, I'll be able to find all the bottles pretty quickly, but, I'm gonna have to go ahead and say this might take a while, guys, so, I will see you guys when I'm done collecting the bottles, alright?
You jump and press the circle button. We'll be right back. press the circle button.
Alrighty guys, so here is the last bottle right here. We have 29 out of 30 bottles, and this last bottle is always kind of difficult for me to get. It's really tricky. I can't remember exactly how to do it. I've tried jumping and paragliding over there, but you just miss it. Yeah, and I tried jumping, and that doesn't work either. I think to get this, guys, you have to go and purchase Sly's new power-up for this episode. So I'm gonna cut it and show you guys me purchasing that new power-up because I think it is needed to get this bottle, guys. So I'll meet you back here once I have it. Alright guys, so here's Sly's new power-up for episode 8. It's called Feral Pounce. It's 1900 coins. You use it to jump over vast distances, as the description says. Now, this power-up is not needed in any way, and it's not useful in the fact that you use it like smoke bomb to get away from guards or anything, but it's probably the funnest. It's probably the most fun out of all the power-ups to use. It's really awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and purchase this really quick, and I will meet you guys back over near the 30th bottle and show you how it works. Alrighty guys, so here we are back at the 30th bottle up there. We cannot jump to it normally, so I'm going to show you guys how to get this 30th bottle. So with the newest power-up that we bought, the Feral Pounce, we're going to... I usually equip it on L1. Actually... Yeah, L1. L1 has always been my smoke bomb because L1 is, you know, I think it's the easiest button to push. And then I put smoke bomb for L2 and stealth slide for R2. This is the gadget setup that I have at the end of the game. This is my favorite gadget setup. L1 feral pounce, L2 smoke bomb, and R2 stealth slide. It's going to take me a little bit to get used to this, the smoke bomb being on L2, but feral pounce is really worth it. So I'll show you guys what you do. When you press L1 using Feral Pounce, you jump really, like, you do this sort of, like, dive thing in the air. And the great thing about this, it does not waste any of your energy bar or your power-up bar. So you can use it as much as you want. It's really awesome. I'm going to show you guys how easy it is to get this bottle now. Just use it. Well, I failed that time, but... and there we go. There is the 30th bottle, and I believe that is the only way to get it, unless, of course, you, later on in the 8th episode, there is a mission where you have to get up high, but, if you're not on that mission, that, I believe, is the only way to get it, is by using Feral Pounce, so it's a really awesome move, as you see right there. But, anyways, guys, that does it for the bottle episode, guys, or the bottle video, and, when we come back next time, we will definitely get started on the reconnaissance mission, which is over there, Blimp HQ Recon, alright, guys? So, until then, see ya.